Now, for anyone who's new to the show, we're Earth. The Ducks are a powerhouse organization with a record 10 state championships.
A little different than the Ducks of the 90s. They actually used to quack.
Adorable.
Quack, 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 Mr. Ducksworth. Quack, quack, quack,
Gordon.
Quack, quack. Stop, quack, quack, quack.
I mean, at this age, if you can't be great at hockey, it's like, don't bother.
Shouldn't kids be able to play sports for fun?
Let's start our own team. A whole group of don't bothers.
Wouldn't even be any good. No offense.
No, I agree. I would not be an acid physically. I have more of a podcast body.
We're going to stick together. You know why?
Because we are ducks. And ducks fly together.
Quack attack is back, Jack!
Quack! Quack! Quack!
DuckBoiiis, the DuckBoiiis are back. The quack attack is back, Jack. We've got Kelsie the Kat, Andrew the Brash Brother,
hello,
me, Lester Aver-Dan. Lester Aver-Dan, yeah, that's
Aver-Dan.
That's
are we?
Period. Like, Lester Aver-Dan.
Are you the center and we're your two wings? Is that like our lineup? Are we
I think
a line?
So.
I think Averman was the centerman, right? He was.
He's so forgettable. Who could know? What was his position?
Got him.
Like in hot in the show, like he's a fun character.
In the games.
In the games, like he doesn't have any.
He doesn't.
Big mode. No. No, he's yeah.
He
is he a playmaking center? Talk
and, you
to
know,
me.
Because as someone who wears glasses but never would wear glasses during a hockey game.
Okay.
He's always kind of looking up at the ref before he's about to drop it, and then he's always kind of got to do the glasses thing.
Yeah.
Classic.
Yeah. Glasses guy.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So
we got that. Yeah.
You made it through the first episode. We gave you the recap of the first episode. We've watched the second episode. We are still in love with this show. We love it so much that we are back with another episode of DuckBoiiis Pod, and we've got more commentary, we've got more jokes, and we have a little bit more purpose this time around. We want to show off some game changers, so we've got that in store. But let's drop the puck on this. Let's the first period has commenced.
Let's duck it up. Let's duck it up.
I ducked it up. That's for
let's
sure.
Let's duck it up. First period.
First
Kelsie,
period.
Tell me about episode 2, Game Changers, on Disney Plus.
Okay, so episode 2 is it's called Dusters. What does that mean? What
Dusters.
Does that mean?
Dusters.
What does it mean?
He's a duster, bud.
Yeah,
what
this is hockey slang. This is very like Letterkenny. This was really popularized after Letterkenny, and makes sense. We've got a Letterkenny alumni in the show, but. It's just someone that is just not very good at hockey.
Okay. Okay, that's, well, that's episode 2, Dusters, they're our friends, the Don't Bothers, this ragtag group of young people, there's new hockey team, they're ahead, it's like their first practice, they're about to, they have their first game coming on Saturday, and we are greeted with them ahead of their first practice, and Alex, Lauren Graham, the Evan's mom, our protagonist, she is prepping the team. She's never coached before, and they have like a, she doesn't want them to skate. She wants them to trust. Did you guys do drama class? It was very reminiscent, obviously. Andrew's done drama class.
I did a few drama classes.
Do you know drama class? Because drama class is trust falls, and that's what this was very reminiscent of.
If you only knew what like advanced drama class was too.
What
like
is it?
University drama class.
What do you
like
do?
Trust
I want to
falls
know.
On acid. It's like
yes.
What it is. It's like laying on the floor while someone just like goads you into going to the darkest trauma of your life. The completely unlicensed. They have no license. Like, you know, like as far as therapy or anything is concerned, to do this to people. I you know how I figured out, like, my true privilege was that I went to drama school and they were like, go to the darkest place. And I was like, yeah, it really sucked when, like, that one person said that mean thing to me. You know, like, I didn't have the places that, like, my classmates had. So that's not really a joke. That's just what, that's just a truth.
That's drama class. That's
drama class.
But what do we think about this? Like, with the, do you think it's important in a hockey team? Cause she's, Alex is really focused on doing things differently. This whole episode, she just wants things to be different than regular.
She's a game changer.
Really wants to approach things from, like, a different angle, but we don't really know as the episode goes on if that is beneficial to winning.
Well, it definitely, if you want to bring a team together, that's one way to do it. She did really get into the players, right? They were supposed to tell, they went around kind of the circle and tossed the puck around. What was it? What puck was that called? The truth puck?
I don't know.
Something like that.
Well, shell.
The trust puck? Trust falls?
The trust puck?
Fall puck.
Well,
I don't know. Shell. Lord of the Flies.
Conch shell.
It was called blank puck, and they were told to share something that everyone knew about them and something that someone what they didn't know about them.
Yeah.
So this was a cool moment for Nick about the whole Don't Bothers.
It's true.
Yeah.
And of course we got to find out something about Nick's home life.
It's inclusive.
Nick has two moms.
Nick has two moms.
Nick has two moms. I love finally. Hockey has two moms.
Hockey moms, yeah.
Yeah.
Another piece of media that a character has two moms. I personally can't think of one, but it's good to see. And again, game changers.
Yes.
They're changing the game in hockey. They're changing the game in pop culture.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Other characters. I mean, there are other characters on the team. You know, we've discussed at length our favorite one. We've shed light on the main character.
Mm-hmm.
But let's just give our listeners the other ones. I mean, again, you've seen the show, right? You're not listening to this without watching Disney
Plus. You're crazy. You're a crazy person if you're listening to the second episode of a podcast. Sorry.
Don't call my Instagram fans crazy. They might just want to support what I do.
They
need
to go watch the show.
Friends. I've had people reply to, like, my Instagram stories being like, you should do more videos where you talk to the camera. Yeah. Like, that's a thing
that's fair.
I deal with. I've told you that. So welcome. Yeah. Welcome.
Well, you know what? I'm sorry. People. I didn't realize I was discriminating against a group of people.
No,
sorry.
No, people are going to listen to this podcast and then be like, this show sounds so good. I'm going to watch the show. And then the show.
Well, then, okay. Well, then, you know what? Then you're not crazy. You just have great taste in podcasts. That's all it is.
You're doing things backwards. Where are we? What?
We've got Maya, right? We've got the popular...
Yeah, so Maya's the popular girl that, like, she said she didn't really fit in. Like, she was struggling to fit in with her group.
Click, right?
Yeah, so she just wanted to start something new. So I love that. I love Maya.
And we got Lauren, the warrior princess.
Lauren's the warrior princess. Yeah. Kind of like the... I don't want
Speaking
to say nerdy,
of
but like
drama
the...
class, she definitely seems like she'd be in drama class. I knew this girl in drama class for sure.
We've got Sam.
Yeah, she was in drama class. Who's Sam?
Sam's the never turns down a dare. He's the one without a spleen.
Right.
He's the
I like him. Yes, I want more of him. Yes, that's fun. I want to see more of his character. I like that he never turns down a dare.
He doesn't have a spleen.
He's a wrecking ball, right?
Like he is.
He's gonna come in.
He's the Bash Brother.
He is. He's kind of the 2021 Bash Brother.
Absolutely.
Hey?
Yeah.
I wonder if we'll get like a second kind of Bash Brother or Bash Sister. Who knows?
Ooh. Yeah, hot takes. Hot predictions here.
That's an official prediction. I'm putting it down. It was just speculation, but now it's a prediction.
And then again. So yeah, that's the team. That's a team as of right now. Like, without counting, I feel like that's just enough to ice a team. But yeah, we'll see where it goes. And let's check in on the other characters. Bombay, what's he up to this time around?
Well, during the they're having their off ice first practice. Evan's like very skeptical. He's like, "Mom, we got a game on Saturday. Like, what are you doing?" So he's like going back and forth. He's going to like knock on Bombay's office, being like, "You gotta talk to my mom." And Bombay's just sleeping on the couch, and he's not having it. He doesn't.
It's nap time.
He's still like very like not into helping, even though like we know he's such a great mentor. Like, we're like, it's right there. This is what they need to succeed. But he doesn't want it. And so it's like, it's still such like an enigma. Like, why? Why does he hate hockey? How could he hate hockey?
Why?
He's Gordon Bombay.
He sleeps during the hockey practice, right? Like the Minnesota Miracle sleep man.
Yeah.
The Twin Mattress City.
So we don't know.
He's got a pretty small bed in his office.
Twin Mattress City. I like
Twin Mattress City. He doesn't want to help Alex. I don't know if they're going to flirt. I don't know. I don't want it. But he's there. He's near. He's near the action, but he's not really lingering. Participating at this point. So.
That's right. It's a slow burn with Bombay. I'm like, I'm hungry for
but
more.
We, yes, but we really see this one that Evan is really looking up to Gordon, right?
Yes.
Already, though. Like, what's why? Why?
Yeah, he's done nothing to warrant this. No. This mentor status.
Outside I don't know. Of he's, his, you know what? He's, he has mystique, though. You know, again, sometimes as a kid, you're just like, oh, this guy's a jerk, but I'm kind of into it. You know, I want to be him.
And there's still a big piece of the puzzle missing with Gordon, right? We don't know what happens between. We still haven't figured out the motive of why he doesn't like hockey.
Yeah.
So we're like, yeah, we'll find out. But so,
we'll
yeah,
find
that's,
out.
That's
a, episode that's... two. Episode two. We don't know. I still don't know.
Well, you know what? That is the end of the first period. So, perfect timing.
Let's talk about a game changer. Let's talk about some game changers in our community. Let's talk about some real game changers. Who is doing stuff in real life?
Mm-hmm.
I recently read an article that I want to share with you guys and our viewers, and maybe we can, like, we're at the point now where we're not, this isn't new information, we're not starting the conversation of this, the conversations have started. It's time for some people that to make a move and to make a difference in the game of hockey, and we haven't quite figured out our role in that, but we're gonna start here. So I want to talk about a man, Mateo
Perus Short.
Yeah, Mateo Perus Short is a 13-year-old hockey player in Montreal, and he experienced some real discrimination on the ice, he got some coverage for it because he spoke out about it, and him and his mother are going to be starting a group to educate people on.
Can share screen a little bit there.
Yes, nice. So they want to start like a basically like how the NHL formed the Diversity Alliance. This is the real life. This is like it in practice. Like, this is grassroots. Yeah.
So yeah. They've had enough of it, and they want their story to be told so that it essentially doesn't happen to other people. And when it happens to other people, well, how do you react to it? And how do you have a support system so that you can go towards two coaches to bring up these issues and to just really have a group that's going, that you know is going to stick up for you in these situations. So he shared his personal message, and he wants to start his group with his mother, Michelle. Hope I have that right. And we want to help out too. And we're going to find out more about his group and how and where this goes and how he changes the game of hockey himself. So we're definitely going to keep tabs on that. You know, just like uh, just we're looking at the minor league systems for our favorite teams. We're looking at
the pipeline.
Next up-and-comer. Yeah, exactly. We're seeing what's coming down the for prospects for worthy groups and initiatives that we want to contribute to. So, my man, Mateo,
and hockey moms. Hockey moms are so amazing. Just like our Evan and Alex, we got Mateo and
Michella,
a superstar.
Superstar in the making here, and he's been just tackling it on head on. Like, 13 years old. He's been playing hockey since he was 8 years old is when he had his first had to confront racism in hockey. Mm-hmm. So, man, he's been doing this for a while, and he's had enough, and we've had enough, and the NHL has had enough. Well, I don't want to say the NHL has had enough, but there's players in the NHL that have certainly had enough. We definitely want the NHL to speak out more on it, and we want
feels like there's an effort being made
to speak out on it. But yeah, definitely, and it's good to see him media picking this up, and I really look forward to seeing where his organization
there you goes go from here. Mateo Peru short, a game changer. Yes.
A game changer.
A game changer.
Not a duster.
Mm-mm. Not a duster. No. Also not a duster, right? It's like any can play. So
he's not a duster.
No, he's not a duster. He said like in the either the final or the semifinal game when he scored a game tying goal and he celebrated. He said he celebrated in the stands. Is what his interview was. I really hope that's true. That he just went in the stands.
I hope so too.
That's a Dean Portman move.
Oh, definitely. Yeah. Dean Portman leads the league in penalty minutes and shirt.
And abs. Per minute, and per abs. 60 minutes.
Yes.
Teenage abs.
Teenage abs. Speaking of teenage sex appeal, let's talk
question
about.
Mark?
Question mark? Is this question a penalty? Mark? Is it a 2 minute minor? I don't
it
know.
It might be.
For creepiness, general creepiness from the writers.
Period. Let's go. Let's hear. But break this one down for me. So what?
They get this equipment by raiding a lost and found, right?
Yeah.
And,
so yes. Gordon gives us a hot tip.
Yeah.
Where it's like, oh, the game's coming up. When like he's just like, well, they've got a lost and found. It's juicy. And yeah, they get a hot tip that they can steal equipment from like the nicer arena. And that's what they do. It's shenanigans. It's fun. My notes from the first episode, I said that like because they're wearing horse helmets and football helmets that like I was like led to believe that like a shopping montage was coming, which is my favorite. That's my favorite thing in any movie.
Losers.
Pretty Woman, like it doesn't matter what the movie genre is, like when someone gets to just like go shopping on someone else's credit card. That's
Mighty Ducks 2 when
that's the best scene. They play Good Vibrations by Marky Mark.
Yes.
Like that's the song. Like it's so good. And
Mr. Tibbles
with the credit
up.
Card. Yeah. So I'm thirsty, hungry for that scene. So basically this is what we get. This is kind of that scene. It's still rewarding. It's team building. But how they plan to get in the arena is by using the dreamy boy Logan from Canada to go charm
the Toronto
desk.
the older woman.
The older woman, but like they're 12 to 14. Is that their age group right here? Like
I think so. That's what they say because that's the age group that Evan's going into that he's too small for.
Yeah. So that's young. That's young to charm a woman. Let me just say right now.
That is. That
that's
is.
Young. You want me to
admit that I'm charmed by his hair? I don't know.
Well, he's cute, but like he's probably like 36 years old.
That's right. Right? Like he's like Annie from Community. He's actually like 35.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But like
they have to shave him after
before every episode.
It works. He's cute. We know he's cute. Yeah.
And they get
we
the
have
equipment.
To check
even,
the search
oh,
engine
Evan
history of the woman who
that...
works behind the behind the desk.
Talk about writing. Evan finds his stick that has been missing that he won the championship with or had an undefeated season with.
Which yes, was magic
never
wand.
Never mentioned before this.
No, did it's, a, magi- it's a magic stick.
The magic stick.
The magic. The magic.
Magic wand. Was it, or did he say magic stick?
I wish it was magic stick, but I believe
magic
it's
stick
wand.
Is a 50 Cent song. So.
Oh, well, I know. Oh yeah.
Oh,
I am the 50 Cent generation. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes. We'd be popping.
But
them
it's
things.
Nice to see that the kids do have proper protective equipment while on the ice, and then once they get on the ice, call back alert, Easter egg, duck egg.
Duck
the beach balls are back.
A beach
the
ball
beach
practice.
Balls are back.
It's not
Jack.
Mighty Ducks without a beach ball practice.
What fun. Have you guys ever played hockey with beach balls?
Definitely whacked a couple
be
beach balls with a hockey stick before, but maybe not on ice.
I think it would be fun. Okay. I haven't.
No.
I don't play hockey.
But they don't actually, they usually don't hit it with sticks in the movies, right? They've always just been kicking it around. Which
right.
Is,
yeah.
That's a
I saw a meme. On shout out to Look at This Russian on Instagram,
yes. Yes.
Where they were kicking there was a man on ice kicking the beach balls at the kids, and the kids
yes.
were falling down. And I yeah. was like, that is the Russian version, and that's how you get the Red Army team. They were all kicked.
That was like a exercise ball, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So they have the first practice,
mm-hmm.
and then leads to the first game.
Yeah.
It's pretty much, it's game
it's what,
time.
It's what we expected, right?
But wait,
yeah.
ahead of the first game, Alex, the mom, surprises the team
right,
with a cardboard box of jerseys.
Oh, we have
jerseys.
To do a jersey breakdown,
a
uniform
jersey, a
breakdown.
Yellow and brown. What are they, yellow and black, yellow and brown?
And I yellow. Thought it was, you know, with the yellow and...
thought with the brown, I thought,
was, I
thought they'd
I thought
go maroon.
Was, exactly. I thought they were going to go...
I am colorblind, so I actually thought it was the Minnesota maroon from like the Golden Gophers, which is gold
yeah.
and maroon.
Yeah.
And I thought it was, and then Dan explained to me that it was brown.
It's brown.
Yeah.
And that's surprising because there are Golden Gopher references. Like, there's merch.
She wears a sweater.
Hoodie, so.
Which
yeah.
is a duck egg because Charlie Conway, Joshua Jackson, wears that in... the OG.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, the original but, Dawson's Creek, yes.
Yeah, and so, and Evan's the captain. Evan wears the C, which is,
he should,
right?
He started
his,
the team.
This is his baby.
I mean, his last name is Morrow, right? So there is a hockey tradition of having guys with last name Morrow be the captain, right?
But, like, it's spelled wrong.
Brandon Morrow was a captain.
Was it spelled the same?
He was.
M-O-R-R.
Yeah.
No, yeah.
Okay.
And then there was, of course, our favorite, Ethan Morrow. And
he was Moreau.
Moreau.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
that's how Connie Moreau spells her name.
Oh,
right.
Mighty Ducks. And I'm waiting
it's
for her to come
egg.
Back. It's
Moreau
duck egg.
To Moreau.
Yeah, but I wanted them to have the same. And then she's like Aunt Connie, and she's going to come
yeah.
back and mentor him. And she's like an Olympian.
Maybe they Americanized it. Maybe they anglicized it, like, purposefully. This is going to be a whole thing with her being a paralegal and going through that process.
Maybe.
Prediction number two.
I'll never forget what Ron McLean once said he was introducing a Dallas Stars and Edmonton Oilers playoff game, and he was talking about the two... Morrows, and he said you can never have two Morrows, and I never understood that phrase. I thought it was maybe like a tomorrow. Never, yeah.
Wow.
Ron McLean. I'll never forget that one though. But Ron McLean.
Ron McLean channeling his inner Gene Principe.
Yeah.
Ron McLean, class act. Okay.
Gene Principe, class act. Even though you know the puns are outrageous, but the dude, he keeps it classy.
Gene Principe. That's what my Sportsnet now, everyone's like, why don't you just stream it? Like, don't pay for Sportsnet. And I'm like, no, my money is going to Gene Principe. And that...
You're writing on your check. Attention.
I am writing a check.
Gene Principe.
I write a monthly check to Sportsnet. Attention, Gene Principe's hair product.
Please.
Well,
nice.
Don't cash checks that your
mouth can't cash.
He can cash them. He can catch him.
I was trying to do a Gene there, but
so yeah, okay. First game.
That you're not willing to Principe.
There
it is.
I will Principe. A very small, only certain people will get these references.
That's okay.
Google
the crossover. The crossover.
Gene Principe on YouTube. You won't regret it. So, yeah, they've got jerseys. Evan's the captain. But guess what? They're bad at hockey. They can't win.
They're bad at hockey.
They're all over the place. Our friend Coob, we haven't talked about Coob yet this episode. Our goalie. True. He's
not good. He's very bad. He doesn't move.
Stuck in video game mode.
Yeah.
He's stuck in video game mode.
His controller is out of batteries.
Yeah, he's out of batteries.
There's potential there. We saw it in the first episode. There's potential there. He's not so steady on skates. He doesn't want to move. So,
exactly.
You know.
But I believe in him.
I believe in him, too.
He's got the sense, right? We know that he's got the reaction time. He just needs a little experience.
That's the end of the second period. Those 10 minutes go quick.
We forgot about the awards, too.
That's okay.
Yeah, but I don't remember what any of the awards are. So
I honestly think that the periods are literally just the clock now.
Yeah,
I think it's okay. I think it just.
I think it works.
Yeah,
it works.
I think it's fine.
Yeah.
I think it's good.
Yeah.
Because we don't have that much to say. So if we
it's true. We need to talk about the uniforms, though, to start the third period.
Yeah.
Because we talked about it a little bit, and we went into the color, and then we got into the duck eggs. But we need to talk about the threads. Let's talk about the threads. So we got a little bit sidetracked with the golden gophers and all the duck eggs and that kind of thing. But what do you think of the logo on the brown and golds? I think, you know, I actually think that the uniforms are pretty crisp. Like they're pretty nice as far as
for what,
don't bother
for what we're dealing with in terms of the name, because we don't have an animal and an adjective to make into a logo. I feel like it's just, that's all we could do.
Are they
going to
stick with this name the whole way?
We're stuck. Yeah, it's already has a sunk cost in the jerseys now, so.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, exactly. That's why I was surprised. I guess. I don't know. What else could they... Because they can't take the Ducks. Like, I'm waiting for, like, that great moment in D2 where they're like, you're Team USA.
Oh,
actually, you're Team USA Ducks. Or, like, in D3 where it's just like, oh, you're the Eden Hall Warriors. You're the Eden Hall Ducks. Like, now it can't be like, they're the Ducks, but they're mean. Now you're the Ducks because you guys have
team
spirit.
They're the don't bother Ducks.
Yeah. So, I don't know.
Maybe. We'll see. We'll
maybe. Not.
The Bombays.
The don't...
Like, Bay? Like, B-A-E.
Oh my
like the
god,
Bombays.
That's what
Bombays.
That's
what
that's
the podcast is supposed to
be
called.
Man, it was between, like, we were really struggling with DuckBoiiis. We settled on DuckBoiiis.
I like DuckBoiiis.
I like DuckBoiiis too.
But Bombays.
Bombays.
It wasn't
just,
Bombays
is
oh my god,
sexy.
Bombays? Damn.
Yeah.
There's
you
that.
We'll
it.
See. Maybe we'll hate Bombay. He's not getting up
true.
Off that couch.
And maybe we will have our you know duck moment where we're no longer the D5 Ducks. We're the Mighty Ducks.
District 5.
But
that's true.
Okay, but we didn't talk about. We just need to rewind before the game where Alex catches Gordon having a secret night skate playing hockey.
Oh,
Like he's secretly playing hockey, so it's like you don't hate hockey. You're having secret night skates.
And you know what?
I'm
starting to think that you don't. You actually like kids. That's what I think too. Because he says that.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, we didn't. That was a duck egg in the first episode. I think
that's
where he
a duck
says,
egg.
I hate hockey and I don't like kids. He says the exact same thing right in the first Mighty Ducks. So
yeah.
I did like.
He's lied to us before, is all I'm saying.
Exactly.
Well, I think he should have kept his hockey playing secret. He was not very good. His skills have.
Oh.
He hasn't aged very well.
Are you assessing a penalty here? Is this what we're getting?
I'm a TM.
Was it really him? Was it really him filming? Andrew.
It was.
It was. I think it was. I think it was. There may have been a skating body double just so that they could get more shots, like long shots, just so that they didn't have to waste his time doing that.
So they didn't have to pay Emilio Estevez big bucks.
Absolutely. Yeah, there may have been because they do. Bucks. It doesn't. It may be a different person, like long shots and like shooting from behind. But like it actually seems like, yeah, he does actually have the ability to be out there skating around and kind of handling the puck.
My notes. If you can read, I wrote, looking like Michael Douglas on ice. Because he looks so much like Michael Douglas on ice. Yeah. I've never seen Michael Douglas skate, but now I have.
And Kirk Douglas and Martin Sheen and Charlie Sheen, they all look the same. I don't know what's going on. I don't know.
Are they related to Kirk Douglas?
They're a clone army of handsome leading men. That's what it is. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's the Mandalorian, and they are the clone army.
And I can't tell if he's had filler. That's another note I have. I want to see more.
I also can't
face.
Tell like
know.
How heavy he is. And I know that's like, whoa, body positivity. I'm not.
No,
I'm,
no, I'm know, just I'm not, curious I'm just about curious. Aging. And it's been like 20 plus years since these movies came out. So
he's eating all this cake. I just, you know, but he's also skating pretty good. So, you know.
But, like, are we to believe he hasn't skated until this new team came around and now he's like, maybe I should skate
That's
again.
The vibe I got.
Well, they said that he burned all of his equipment the year that the Minnesota North Stars went to Dallas.
He just couldn't handle it.
which to me, like, that's the first time they've actually referenced that, that the North Stars have moved.
I hope we get some like him hating the Minnesota Wild commentary.
Yeah,
like,
where's that?
I would love that. I would.
Who's on the Wild right now?
On like this Mighty Ducks canon, like the timeline and stuff, right? Because they make reference to the team moving, which never happened before. Mm-hmm.
So will they make reference to the actual Mighty Ducks of Anaheim that played in the NHL?
Oh my gosh, can they?
That would be something, wouldn't it?
They have to.
So does the Mighty Ducks of Anaheim NHL team slash the Anaheim Ducks that we know now that play in the Honda Center, or maybe they play in a new one now. I don't know.
No, it's
but,
still the Honda Center.
Do they exist in the Mighty Ducks
in this universe?
Cinematic universe, in the Game Changer universe? Do they exist? Because if the Minnesota Wild do...
Yeah, of course they do. But I think they do.
Yeah, because we got Paul Kariya in D3.
Right.
Right.
So the jerseys are the same in D2.
Right, right.
Yeah. But, so yeah, for them to now just like look the other way, that's a little bit weird.
Yeah. I'm more curious if they ever make a Wild Wing reference. Of course, the...
Get him.
The mascot of the
foul
team.
That's a foul.
You're out of the animated series.
That's
you're
a check.
Always mentioning the animated series. I love Wild Wing. I don't know.
Buffalo
Let's
Wild
get
Wing.
Also
not a sponsor.
Teemu Selanne.
Let's get him on the pod.
And
let's ask him about his outdated television set.
Oh my God! Yeah, you see him showcase his kid on Instagram.
Teemu.
I love that about him.
I even got my mom to update from. She had that exact same television set, and I was like, "Mom, like it's time.
That's
like everything's
same.
In
it's 500 pounds.
Everything's in H.
That's
yeah,
the
it's
same
500
TV
pounds
that we watch D2 on.
Yeah, yeah.
You'd be at home sick, and it'd be on TV, or you put the VHS in, and you'd watch it over and over and over.
But I love
that. Movie like that.
Teemu Selanne is—he's so humble. He's great. That's why he's.
You know what? It fits, and it fits the cabinet perfectly.
Playing.
He clearly had that made for that television, and you know I get
he's
it.
He's like, what?
It's the aesthetic.
I'm supposed to redo my cinema room? No, I'm busy.
You think
he's
I am?
A great
you
dad.
You think I am
he's a
made
great
of money?
Dad.
I bet you he changed the channel by flipping the stick around and poking the knob on the TV.
That's a good one. I'd
love
to see that.
He's one of two retired Ducks. There's only two. As far as I know. Last time I was there.
Numbers retired.
Yeah. Kariya and Selanne. And I was just like, wow.
Those are the ones.
No
one. Yeah. Yeah.
No. You can have a J.S. Jagir Knight, but you can't retire the jersey.
Not yet. So, okay, back to the game. They play hockey. They lose. They lose. The Don't Bothers lose. And Alex is just like, so what? We're having fun. It doesn't matter. And then Evan's like, no, Mom. Actually, getting your ass. They say ass. Like, I think they get like one swear per ep. And Evan says, getting your ass kicked streaming that bad isn't fun at all. We have to get better. Yeah. But no, Evan.
The funniest part in the episode happened in this game when the team is getting clobbered, and Nick is about to get open ice hit on Nick, and he says, "Tell my mothers I love them."
That's true, because during Trust Puck, we found out
that he was the
product of a household with two moms.
Oh my gosh! Again, the timing of this kid, you don't see it coming. And
you don't see, no, the comedic timing is crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You've seen it in media before. Oh, tell my mom I love them. But no, just the way he says it plural, it's so funny. In a nice way. Like, it's a nice funny. It's nice, wholesome funny.
So,
that's the end of the third period. Yeah, it doesn't have to be. We can go like.
Well, I was just gonna say I'm basically done. I'm basically done with the third period. But I say that like, Evan's like, we have to get better. This isn't actually fun. And then they go back on the ice like a true leader. You know, what's that? And they practice. And in classic
Herb Brooks style.
And in classic Mighty Ducks hockey sports movie anything, now they're gonna be good at hockey. Now it's just like they decided to work, and now they will be good at hockey.
I hope so.
So that's how the episode ends. So it's just like, okay, let's get there. Let's figure it out.
Perfect. Yeah. Perfect timing.
Who was your players of the game? Let's hit me with the
three stars. The
players of the game. Three stars of the game. Third star. Who do we got?
So third star is Logan, our Justin Bieber Canadian cute boy Toronto native hockey player that's not so good at hockey but is so good at having nice hair and being cute. And he works. Like, they were able to like utilize his charm and his charisma, and he got them into the place where they needed to burgle.
Yes. Yes. Where burgle needed, as a verb. Wonderful. That's
where
great.
They needed to go burgle and steal helmets and skates and all of these impossibly expensive things. But Logan is a star. He's fun. I love it. If I was a young girl, yes. Thank you for including Logan.
What if you were like an older woman who worked at a sports complex?
That's weird. See, like, I am that older woman. Like, I am a boy crazy older woman. Like, I love boy bands. I love cute everyone. Zac Efron. I don't care who you are. Like, but like young boy, like, no, that's not a thing. That doesn't carry over. Yeah, so like,
fact check. How old is this actor?
Yeah, I need to know. Yeah. I think he's got to be like 19 minimum. Is he 19? Is he 19?
Bet he's 16.
Is he legal to Kiefer buy alcohol in
O'Reilly.
Canada? Yeah, Kiefer. That's a fun name.
Kiefer one O'Reilly.
One of Wayne Gretzky's best friends, Kiefer name. Sutherland.
Kiefer O'Reilly.
How old is he? 18.
Born in 07.
I can't do that math.
It's not good. The math is not good.
Yeah, it's not good. We better we don't do the
14.
Math.
14.
14? No.
Yeah.
14?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Kids we'll, are that handsome.
We'll cut this
14?
Part out.
No, it's fine. It's fine. I'm a mom. I think kids are handsome.
No, it's totally. Like, you know what? That's like the get out of jail free card. You're a mom. That's.
I'm a mom.
It's all good.
No,
it's all
but
good.
Like 14.
No, you can. Yeah.
Wow. Really? Wow.
That's what it says.
Him. Good for him and just having a career.
We hope you have a long career, Kiefer.
Second star.
Evan, Evan. Yeah. Second star.
Evan. Yeah. Don't treat him like Charlie Conway. No. Charlie.
No, Evan. Like Evan. We said in the first episode, Evan is way more likable than Charlie Conway. And but like Evan cares. And I think
he did get an award for caring about hockey the most.
Exactly. I think the it's cool to care. Yep. I think it's really cool to care. Yes. And he just wants to do well. He wants to show up for his team, his friends. He's so on board. And he plays well. He's good at hockey. He's trying his best.
He bothers
and he cares. So second star, Evan.
Boom.
Evan Morrow.
The first star from the Don't Bothers.
No one is surprised.
Nicholas.
Nick the Stick. What's his last name?
He doesn't have a last name in this.
It is. It's something small. Maxwell it's a small Simpkins. Word. No, it's Maxwell a small Simpkins. Word. It's a small word. I can't remember.
It's not online.
Are you
serious?
Is it on
Wikipedia?
It's something that ends in a Z.
Oh, yeah. It's just Nick.
It's just Nick.
Maxwell's. What? Is it on IMDb?
Yeah, get it. He has a jersey. It's like.
Oh, yeah. He would have a jersey. Yeah.
It's
yeah.
something small. What is it's it? Like it's a small word.
We're looking it up.
It's a small word.
Mighty.
Cut this out. We're just me.
Is the good stuff here.
This is the good stuff. Okay,
Mighty
so
Ducks game changers.
Hey, Andrew, look that up real quick.
Yeah, you were supposed to be that guy. I'm the guy now.
I demand to know his last name. It's like Paz.
Mighty Ducks game changers. There we go. Oh no, Mighty Ducks the animated series.
Hey,
Oilers one.
Okay, Nick Gans. Gons.
Thank you.
G-A-N-Z.
Thank you. It's a small word. It ends in Gans. Z. Gans. Nick Gans, number one star overtime.
We are all fans.
He did not score.
Of Nick Gans.
Maybe he will.
There it is. There's
maybe
the pot.
He will.
That's the pot.
Nick Gans fans.
Nick Gans, Gans fans. What did I say? The Bombays.
The Bombays.
Bombays. So good.
God.
The Bombays. Nick Gans fans.
Yeah.
We've got hashtags. I think we have hashtags. I think that's
we have hashtags for days.
Nick is great. He's so funny. I love his whole approach being like, my best friend Evan, like he doesn't know, we might be best friends. Like it's very cute. Yeah, like it's so cute and fun. And yeah, who cares? We don't care that he's not good at hockey or anything. We just love to see him participate. And he's so likable and he's so funny. And he's the first star. Until someone comes along and is better, he will be the first star.
I wonder
about his old best friend, though, because he did have a podcast with...
Oh, the girl?
The announcer,
and you know what?
She's held her own when she's announcing the first Ducks game.
She has,
and
yeah.
it's really funny that she's with her dad. Like, I think that's really funny. I love that. I love the daughter-father
dynamic. He's an accountant, right?
Yeah.
I think, yeah.
And he's like... Yeah, I love that.
Maybe dads. So. Maybe.
Yeah, let's get some dads.
Yeah.
Dads in the mix.
Let's get dad on the pod.
Let's get dad on the pod. All of our dads, let's get our dads to take over the podcast one episode.
The guys that don't want
a nightmare.
Change at all.
No. No.
But we hope you enjoyed our recap. We hope that you enjoyed our game changer segment. We want to showcase more game changers in our community,
unscripted
in our
game
sport
changers.
and people are doing it big in real life, and as soon as this drops, we want to show Mateo some love and support him in his initiatives. And if you guys know of anyone else that you want to let us know about, any game changers that you know about that you want us to know about, we'll chop that up, we'll fix that. You let us know, we want to hear from them. So that's us, that's episode 2. That's Kelsie the Kat.
Dusters is dusted.
That's Kelsie the Kat. That's Andrew the Brash Brother.
Quack.
That's me.
Quack.
Lester Aver-Dan. And the DuckBoiiis, a.k.a. the Bombays, a.k.a. the Triple Freaks, a.k.a. the Nick Gans fans.
We out.